Okay, guys, welcome to today's webinar. My name is Franz Magane from RJ Connect. This is our second RJ Connect Tech Hub webinar. So in today's webinar, we'll be sharing IoThings 4510. Now, the agenda for today is going to be about, The agenda for today is going to be about why MOCs are embedding IoThings and IoThings 4500 solution. And then most importantly, because we'll be focusing on the IoThings 4510 series, we'll do some introduction into the unit and we'll look at the supporting protocols, cloud connectivity, and finally the user applications. Now let us look at why MOCs are embedded in IoThings. As you've already seen, most of us are familiar with iLogic and IOPAC. As you can see here, MOCs is embedded these devices, these units here, but they don't have the capability to connect, for instance, into the cloud. So they've seen the gap and the need for a unit that can be able to do some cloud connectivity and cloud processing. And that's why MOCs has embedded the IoThings 4500 series. And the unit, they come with two series you'll see as we continue with on the presentation. As for the IoThings, it starts with the IO, which is the MOCs core. And the thing, it connects to the compact size, as the reason is nowadays more and more customers want to change the cabinet to smaller size to save the cost. So the size and weight of the equipment is important. And for X, as you can see, it's IT information technology or operational technology convergence. It follows the IoT and industrial 4.0 trend. IT and OT world are getting closer. So more IT people want to get the data from the field to do the data analytics, but they don't have any idea what is Modbus, for instance. So IoThings series wants to help the customer to convert the field side data to IT protocols such as MQTT, RESTful API, and SNMP. It will help IT engineers to easily get the data. As for the things, it's like things, which is like things smart or something. It means that for all the IoThings series, all the units has the capability to do some self-intelligence, such as events, alerts, or to help customer to manage the error handling. And the IoThings 4500 series, as you can see on the left-hand side here, we have the IoThings 4533, which is the MOCs advanced controller modular, which the engineers can develop or install their own programs on that unit. It's like an industrial computer, which the users can use the MOCs APIs, which they already pre-developed inside the unit, the pre-installed. You can use either C or C++ or Python on that. And the IoThings 4533 operating system is based on MOCs industrial Linux, which is kernel 4.4 and Debian 9. IoThings 4533 can directly connect to the cloud Scala via OPC UA here, as you can see, protocol, and also to the cloud via MQTT. And you can also use the RESTful API, for instance, if you have a web HDMI, so you can use a RESTful API. From your right-hand side here, you have the IoThings 4510. It is an advanced modular remote I/O which support different protocols such as Modbus, MQTT, SNMP, and RESTful API. For operation technology protocol, IoThings 4510 support Modbus TCP, and for IT, which is information technology protocols, IoThings 4510 support RESTful API, MQTT, and SNMP version 3. And this SNMP version 3, as you can see here, is the only, the IoThings 4510 is the only unit remote IO modular that support the SNMP version 3. If the customer needs secure protocols, they can use RESTful API over HTTPS, MQTT over TLS, which is Transport Layer Security, or SNMP Vision 3. On this webinar, I will mainly introduce IOThings 4510 Advanced Modular Remote I/O, and is the only one which I said it supports SNMP Vision 3. Now, Moxa has also created the IOThings 4500 series, a power calculator, which is a web application where the customer can calculate how many power modules are needed for their application. And to open this power calculator, you go to moxa.com website, navigate to products, navigate to controllers and IOS. You click on this one, then it will open another web page where it shows you the Moxa's controllers and IOS. Then you select advanced controllers and IOS, and on that page you click on the link here. You'll have this link here where you click on IOThings 4500, a power calculator. And then the next slide, I'll show you how the power calculator looks like. This is the power calculator. It is the web application that Moxa has created here. As you can see here on top here, it's the information on the modular itself. For instance, on this example here, we selected IOThings 4510. You can also select a 4533, but no, because we're mainly focusing on 4510. So I selected 4510 here, as you can, as a modular. And you can see there is we have three modules which are added on the unit here, which gives us also we can add up to 32 modules here. And you see there is a system power here, which shows us the more you add the modules, this values here changes. And it shows you also here the field power and the available power here, very importantly. And you can also select here or simulate here to say you want to use a 12 volts VDC power for your field power, or you can use a 24 volts. If you click here, it changes to 24 volts. So how to add the modules here is easy. You just go to the module that you want to select here. You double click on it and then it gets added into here, into the modular. And then if you want to remove it, for instance, then you just click on that modular, you drag it into this bar here. Then it's removed. Okay. Now let's look at the introduction for IOThings 4510. The IOThings 4510 is an advanced modular remote I/O which supports the multiple IT protocols and security functions, making the ideal solution for IoT application. So IOThings has a unique mechanical design that reduces the amount of time required for installation and removal to simplify deployment and maintenance time. It supports Modbus RTU master protocol for retrieving field site data from serial meters, and also support OT/IT protocol conversion, which we'll cover as we continue on the presentation. The hardware overview. As you could see, the IOThings 4510 support a standard operating temperature and also the wide temperature here. So you can see minus 20 to 60 or minus 40 to 75 degrees. And it also has got the dual LAN ports here, where you can use it to daisy chain the units on the network. Or you can use this ports here as a switch, where you can connect maybe a HDMI here and the one going into your SCADA. And it also has 3-in-1 serial ports, which is RS-232-422-485, where you can connect your serial devices here, such as your power meter or energy meter or flow meter. On the right-hand side here, you see that it allows us to add up to 32 modules, which gives us enough IOs to read from the field. And it also got some LEDs here, which shows the status of the module. And on the other side here, it shows you maybe for instance, the analog status, the IO status here. And it also got the tool-free installation which allows the users to easily remove the modules from the unit here. You just push this in, then the modules, you just pull the modules up. So that beside that, iOThings has got that mechanical design which allows the customers to install and release it without the need of tools. So you don't need to use any tools for this modular. And let's look at the protocols which are supported on the iOThings 4510. The iOThings 4510 is just what you need by supporting the most often used protocol for retrieving IO data. Here are the protocols that are supported: Modbus, SNMP, RESTful API, and MQTT. On the next slide, we'll look at these protocols in more details. The first one is Modbus. What is Modbus? Modbus is a communication protocol developed by Modicon System to transmit data over serial line between electronic devices. This serial communication protocol was introduced in 1979 as a messaging protocol between devices connected through buses on networks. It provides a connection between servers and clients located on different devices, and it operates on an application layer of an OSI module. We have Modbus RTU or ASCII, which transmit data over serial line, and Modbus TCP, which transmit data over Ethernet. And the iOThings 4510 has a built-in Modbus gateway that converts a Modbus RTU to Modbus TCP, SNMP, RESTful API, and MQTT protocols. Now let's see how to enable the service on the iOThings 4510. You log into the device by entering the IP address of the device on the website, on the web page. As you can see, 192.168.127.254 is the IP address of the iOThings here that we're trying to demonstrate for this presentation. You click on security, go under settings, service settings, then you navigate to Modbus. You need to ensure that these text box here are checked so that the service is enabled. As you can see here, we got two Modbus protocols here. We got Modbus TCP as a slave on the Ethernet side, where, for instance, if you got a SCADA, then the unit becomes a slave on the Ethernet side. And then we also have Modbus RTU master, which is for the serial bus. Yeah. And if, for instance, if this is the only setting that you wanted to configure on the unit, remember to click save and restart. Otherwise, the changes that you made on this unit won't be saved. SNMP, which stands for a simple network management protocol, is used by network devices to exchange management information on the network. It's an application layer protocol and part of the transmission control protocol over Internet protocol, which is TCP/IP suite. The SNMP architecture consists of the following: managed devices, which can be printers, workstations, and remote IO devices to resources like routers and switches. The agent, which are programs that are tied to the local devices to the purpose of collecting, storing, and signaling the presence of data from these environments. And we got finally the network management status, which is, this is the base that is shared between the agents and SNMP managers. It provides the memory and processing functionality to fuel the network management. All these components which are mentioned here, they gather information to bring it back to the network requester. For this instance, we can have the MXView as our SNMP, as our network management system or software on the network. And SNMP protocol comes with three versions. We got SNMP version 1, which is the initial version of the protocol. It is easy to set up and is defined in RFC 11155 and 1157. SNMP version 2 is the revised version of SNMP version 1 with enhanced protocol package type, transport mapping, and MIP structured element. SNMP Vision 3 adds both encryption and authentication mechanisms, which can be used together or separately, making this the most secured version of SNMP protocol. And the iThings 4510 support all SNMP visions, including SNMP Vision 3, to ensure secure data transmission. Now, to enable the service on the unit, you log into the unit, you click on Security, Service Settings, you navigate to SNMP Agent. You need to make sure that you check the checkbox here so that the service can be available. Then you can click Save and Restart. MQTT, which stands for Message Queuing Telemetry Transport, is a simple messaging protocol designed for constrained devices with low bandwidth. So it's the perfect solution for Internet of Things application or IoT application. And it was invented in 1999 by Dr. Andy Stanford Clegg and Alan Nipper. And the basic concept that you guys need to understand when it comes to MQTT is the publish or subscribe, messages, topics, and the broker here. So the publish or subscribe is what we will be subscribing to. And then the messages becomes the information that is being sent on the network by the devices on the network. And the topics, for instance, it can be, let's say, a motor started, and that value that is transmitted when the value is started for, let's say, 2, for the motor started or 4, it becomes the message. And then we can either subscribe or publish into that. And the broker becomes a server client service, which interprets the message here that we'll be publishing and also that we'll be subscribing to. For instance, we can take this example as the Zoom meeting that we have, the presentation we have at the moment. We can take this presentation, the meeting here, as the broker, and we can take us, including myself, as the subscribers. So we pop the information that I'm giving to you guys, you can be imagined or visualized as the information that we're publishing into the broker here, into the presentation. And the information is forwarded to all subscribe and candidate, which are you guys that I have trained us for today. And to enable the service on the unit, you log into the unit again, you go under security, you go on service settings, then you ensure that you check the service here, the MQTT client. By default, this service here, it's not enabled, so you need to ensure that you check this service so that it can be able, the unit can be able to provide you with this service. And let's look on how does MQTT work. As we have said, that MQTT is a publish or subscribe protocol that allows each of network devices to publish to a broker. The clients connect to this broker here, which then mediates the communication between the devices. Each device can subscribe or register to a particular topic. When another client publishes a message on a subscribe topic, the broker forwards the message to any client that has subscribed. For instance, these two, these five things here and the computer here becomes the MQTT clients. So both of these need to subscribe to the same topic in order for them to be able to exchange information. So, for instance, when the iOthings publishes data, let's say to a high temperature, the MQTT broker reads the information and it forwards it to the subscribe MQTT client. So then the information is sent to the SCADA, for instance. And the same applies from the computer here. It can also publish to the same topic and the iOthings also subscribe to that topic. RESTful API, which is the API stand for Application Interface Program. This one, it uses the request to read and write, the HTTP request, to read and write data on integrated devices. And RESTful API is a software code that is pre-designed and implemented mostly by the manufacturers to save the time of software developers, engineers, and software system integrators. And the RESTful APIs are suitable for cross application and cross device topology. As you can see here, you can have a RESTful API here where it's shared among these devices here. You can have a web application that is integrated on this one here, and also the mobile one here, and also a database service that is also using this RESTful API code here. So it allows two or more software programs to communicate with each other and are logical tries for building applications that allow users to connect and interact with cloud services. Now let us look on how to enable the service on the unit. You log into the unit by entering the unit IP address, click on security, service settings, then you navigate on RESTful API, you check the checkbox. You can either you enable a RESTful API via HTTP, and if you need security to ensure that the data here that is transmitted through this protocol here is secured, you enable HTTPS. And you click save and restart. So let us look at the value proposition on the IoThings 4510. For security, the IoThings 4510 service is compliant with IEC 62443 level 1, and it follows the confidential, integrity, and availability principle. The IoThings 4510 has an easy auto module configuration feature that enables the user, to make few simple changes with no reconfiguration effort required on both the unit and the SCADA software. And we will look at these options here as we continue. And under connectivity, the IoThings 4510 support MQTT, as I've mentioned, and it also has got the built-in Modbus gateway, which converts RTU into the IT protocols, such as MQTT, SNMP, and RESTful API. Let us take a look on the easy auto module reconfiguration feature on the IoThings 4510. Moxa has realized on the general IO modular that when changing the module order, users need to configure the modules and the Modbus addresses in the SCADA again. As you can see, when you move a module here, or if you remove it here, you still need to go back into your SCADA here and redo the Modbus addresses and the module, the general modular here, IO here, it doesn't keep that addresses. So if anything changes here, then you still need to do some changes on the SCADA here. But the IoThings 4510 modular, the module reconfiguration can be completed with a simple click without changing the Modbus addresses, which can greatly cut down on the time needed for deployment. And we will look on how that works. So you can log into the device, you navigate to module, click edit. And when you click on edit here, so the IoThings will detect that there are modules inserted, moved, or removed. And as you can see, after you click edit, this is the next slide that has a dialog box that you have. And you need to click on automation. And you click on automating, it reads all the connected or the installed modules on the unit here. And then you can click save. And another thing which is very important also to do while you're still here, you can rename your IO modules here. So when you're using, for instance, the MQTT services, if you want to select the topics, then you know that maybe this one here, this module is for plant one, or maybe it's for the lights, or it's for the generator, for instance. So when you select your topics there, you'll know that maybe the digital input zero is from the generator module or the plant one module. Okay, and then let us look at the connectivity, cloud connectivity, where the IoThings 4510 series support. This protocol can be connected to the cloud. You can use MQTT to connect to the cloud. Or if you are using, for instance, as I mentioned before, if you're using a web HMI or network management system for data supervision on a private cloud, you can make the connection using the RESTful API or SNMP respectively. As you see here, the cloud connectivity via MQTT, how that can be achieved is the unit here with the IoThings. They act as an edge on this example here. And then we have the IoT gateway device here. With this gateway here, it can be any IoT device that can be able to convert this. For instance, you can have a UC here that can that will be able to convert from, let's say, from a Modbus into MQTT protocol, or Modbus RTU to Modbus TCP, or Modbus here into RESTful API, or useful data here into MQTT. And this IoThings 4510 modular is the first remote IO with user configuration topics under MQTT, and is the first modular remote IO which support transport layer over transport layer security 1.2 for data encryption. And we will see how that can be achieved. So first thing first is to ensure that you enable the service on the unit by looking into the unit, going to security. As I said before, ensure that you check the checkbox for MQTT client. Then you can rename the topics, for instance, if you want. If you want to rename, you make them meaningful. You go under IO, then you put let's say a high temperature, low temperature, motor started. By default, you notice that it will be a DI0, the same, the naming that is here, that you see here, which is referred here, it will be here. So you can change that so that it becomes meaningful for you. Then, and the MQTT broker, how to enter the details of the broker or of your cloud server. Go to protocol, choose MQTT. Then you can enter the IP address of your broker here. As you can see here, we used a local computer as our broker here. And then the communication port, which is the default port of MQTT, is 1883. So if, for instance, you're using a cloud server as your broker, you also need to make sure that you put the IP address from the broker here. And you can see here, we also have a TLS, which is Transport Layer Security. And then by default, it's disabled. And if you need to secure this data that is going to be transmitted through this protocol here, you can enable the service. And then the publish or subscribe. For publish and subscribe, after you enter your broker information by going into, let's say, protocol MQTT, you click on topic settings. Under topic settings, that's where we have a publisher here. You need to enable the topics that you want to publish to. For instance, as you can see here, high temperature has been enabled, low temperature has been enabled. So all this becomes my topic into the broker that we're going to publish into. And very importantly is to ensure that all that you have enabled here, all the topics that you enable here, you also subscribe to them here. You click on subscribe, then you enable the topics here. Otherwise, you'll be publishing but not being able to subscribe. Because how does the subscribe work? It works like it reads and it's like read and write. So the publisher will be writing and the subscriber will be reading. And here I've just listed some examples. Only two examples on how we can have we can have this solution here. We can have a computer on the network here, which acts as a MQTT broker and a client, which we can run the SCADA here. And this computer here can also be the broker here. And IoThings becomes the MQTT clients. And then for this computer here to be able to interpret this service here, you need to install the Mosquito service here. And then the two will interchange the information. As you can see, the other one will be publishing and subscribing all the time. Or if, for instance, you have the public static public IP address of your cloud server, then you can push the information directly into your cloud from the unit into the cloud. Yeah, via MQTT or RESTful API. And on the left-hand side here, what we have here, we have the IoThings device here, which acts as an edge device. And we have the UC8100, which becomes and our IoT gateway and an MQTT client. So how this scenario works is the UC will be reading and writing data from the IoThings device via Modbus TCP. And that data here on the UC, you can install a Node-RED, and inside the Node-RED, you can install MQTT Node, which enables the unit to act as an MQTT client. So now the information that we'll be receiving here, it will be pushed into the client in form of a publish, and it will be read in form of a subscribe from the cloud. And the IoThings 4510 support Modbus RTU master for retrieving field site data from serial meters. So we can have a power meter here, a flow meter, serial meter, or other serial devices that you guys want to connect into the unit. After collecting the data, users can convert serial data to a variety of protocols, including Modbus TCP, SNMP, MQTT, and RESTful API, allowing users to get field site data in their protocol of choice. This two-in-one design reduces system complexity and the amount of space required in network topology, as well as overall installation time. Now, to set up, to configure the serial port on the unit, you log into the unit, you click on serial port, you select the serial port that you want to configure. For instance, on this example, we selected serial port 1. Under serial port 1, serial port settings, here you can see the serial mode. You can change the mode here, either to serial 4852 wire, 42 RS232. And the parity AC is set to none, so bit is 1. And you can also specify your transmission speed here, which is your baud rate. So you can see we set it to 11.5200, and the data bit is 8, the flow control is none. And let us look at the security feature on the IoThings 4510. The IoThings 4510 complies with support all the security functions listed in the level 1, which is defined by Moxa. As you can see here, the users have got the option to change the default IP address. They will be warned if maybe, let's say, when you log into the unit and you haven't changed the IP address of the unit, it will notify you that it has been recommended for you to change this IP address. I mean, this password, sorry, not IP address. Sorry for that. But you also need to make sure that you write down this password, because otherwise you're gonna forget it and lock yourself out. For the systems here, as you can see, it supports all the system features here, where the users can also do a firmware or configuration integrity. And all these firmwares is been encrypted on the unit. So the IoThings 4510 follows the basic principle of information security by preventing the theft of sensitive information or programs in the device by unauthorized users. It ensures that data cannot be added or removed or modified by unauthorized people during a data transmission, and it prevents the device from shutting down by the attackers. Now, if you want to secure data over, let's say, SNMP, so users can go under protocols, click on SNMP, then you choose SNMP version 3, and you enter your SNMP version 3 settings here, username and password. And then the most popular encryption algorithm used by SNMP is MD5 here, as you can see, which stands for Message Digest Algorithm. However, since MD5's security weaknesses can be exploited by hackers, cybersecurity experts suggest using a more secure algorithm such as SHA-2, which is SHA, Secure Hash Algorithm 2, to protect sensitive information. And Moxa's IoThings 4510 support the SHA-224 and SHA-256 encryption algorithm, both of which belongs to the SHA-2 family. And if you want secure data over MQTT, click on protocol, MQTT, you enter your broker details, connection settings, you enter your broker details here, then you enable TLS, which is transport layer security. Then you check the authentication, you enter your username, as you can see, I just say admin and the password here, and the data will be secured. And let us look at the user cases on iOThings 4510. The iOThings 4510 can be applied on the data center environmental monitoring system, where, for instance, the users can require more IOs. For instance, let's say we need, or on this application, we can need 20 analog inputs and 30 digital outputs, and also as 20 analog inputs. So these devices are the best option for this scenario. And as you can see, we can have a network management system here on the control room, such as MXView, where we can use SNMP protocol to pull information from the devices. And another case where you can apply this is a chemical plant monitoring system, where the solution is an industrial edge to cloud solution, where users, if for instance, we have three plants which are not interconnected to each other, then we can have the iOThings, which is connected to the IoT gateway, for instance, a UC8100, and the UC will connect to the cloud server over the internet. So both sides will connect into the cloud server and send information, and the control center will also read the data from the cloud server here. Another solution is a solar farm monitoring and control system, where we can have the solar panels here, which are connected to the inverter, and then inverters can be connected into the serial port, which will be transmitting data over Modbus RTU. And this data, as we said before, that this unit there, it does the protocol conversion. It will convert the information that it gets here into, for instance, into MQTT. And on the network here, we can have a computer which acts as an MQTT broker. And we have another one which it becomes an MQTT client, which displays our SCADA here. And the critical power system. The iOThings 4510 can be installed on these solutions, where the users, maybe let's say for instance, they want to read the relay status and also switch on the LEDs, like the lights on and off. Air traffic management system. The iOThings 4510 can be deployed at an airport and to acquire serial or digital and analog data from runaway lines, power lines, navigation aids, and then transmit the real-time data to the control center. The control center can pull the remote IOS data periodically via SNMP to ensure that all monitoring data is up to date. For data security, users can configure SNMP Vision 3 and SNMP Vision 3 TRAP, which support authentication and data encryption on the iOThings 4510. And let us look at the questions. That's it for today. We're going to look at the questions. If we have questions or not. Where is it? Where's the chat? I'm looking at the chat here. Please bear with me. Oh, sorry. I got a chat here. I'm not sure if we still have time. I'm just going to try to answer a few questions. I got a question here.
Hello, guys. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you, Johan.
Hello, guys. Sorry, I don't mean to interrupt, Franz. I have replied to some of the questions. Just one question. The 4510 does not support logic programming. You cannot write logic on iThings 4510, but on the 4533, it is possible to use the Linux operating system to install packages for Python and C and JavaScript and so on. Just correct me on that if I'm wrong, Franz.
Okay.
Is that correct, eh?
Yes, that's correct. Yes, on the iThings 4533, which is the one that runs the Linux Debian one, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And in the future, it will, the 4533 will support Codasys and also Node-RED in the future.
Yes. Yes.
But currently, it's only the Linux platform at the moment.
Yes, and then it because the Moxa is designed, has developed the APIs for the customers, which are, they can either use Python or C++ to retrieve the IO data at the moment.
Great, great.
Yes, which we're going to share on the webinar for iThings 4533 on how to easily read the IO status from the unit using either Python or C++.
Yes.
Yes.
A question from Jeremiah. Is it possible that you can read data from an existing PLC? In the case where it's a serial PLC, maybe yes. Then it will convert the mod, if it supports Modbus, it will convert that Modbus protocol from RTU to TCP. But on the 4510, if it's not Modbus, you won't be able to read data from other PLCs or devices if they don't support Modbus.
Yes. How many 32 serial power monitors can I connect to the 4500 in Cascade? Maximum number of serial power monitor allowance. You mean,
Yes, I was busy checking the data sheet. On the Modbus protocol, typically on a Modbus serial bus, you would only be limited to 32 serial devices on a single bus. That's a limitation from Modbus, not the device itself. I just want to confirm that that is the case. But continue on, Franz. I'll just quickly have a look here.
Okay. So I'm just going to answer another question here, which says the maximum serial power meters I can connect to the 4500. Is it 32? Or in Cascade? I'm not sure what the customer is trying to mean, but on the serial port here, is for instance, if it's the we're using a Modbus RS485, we can designate the unit up to 32 on the serial side. And then if does it mean on the IO, you can add up to 32 IO modules on the unit.
Yes.
Yes. And what operating system is running on the iThings gateway? Yeah, I think the customer here is referring to the UC. So the UC is running the Moxa's embedded Linux kernel, which is 4.4, which is running Debian 9. So it's Linux.
Yes. Is there any other questions that we missed?
I'm trying to check another one. I think some of them you've already answered somewhat.
Yes.
You can get it. Okay, I think this one you already answered, where a customer asks, somewhere I read that you can get it with Node-RED. Is that true? Yeah, that's true. With the coming modules on the iThings 4533, that's where Johan has already mentioned that it will come with a Node-RED. Yeah, Moxa is still busy with it.
Yes.
I think
but not available on the 4510. Remember, guys, the 4510 is just advanced remote IO with support for IT and OT protocols. It's not a programmable unit. It is just for you to collect data from your field devices and send them to other platforms, such as cloud platforms or PLCs, to collect that data and then process that data for your process control systems.
Okay, yes, yeah, just to make sure, it's not a computer. So the 4533 is an industrial computer. It's like a Raspberry Pi, but it's an industrial.
Yes.
Yes, the other one is just like a normal one, which is advanced. I would like a demo on reading IOs using C or Python addressing IO. Yes, we've already done that before the lockdown on our offices. We already did that. So we can actually give you the demo. That's okay. Is that okay, Mr. Yuan?
Yes, yes. I think that's going to be part of our
next presentation. Webinar. Yes.
Yes.
On the next webinar, we'll cover that also, yes.
One of the next ones, yes.
Okay. I think that's all.
Yes.
I'm not sure if we miss another question, can we get these questions, Yuan, and include them on our webinar, maybe? I mean,
I'm saving the chat now, so yes. I have all the questions. If we missed someone, we'll email you directly or address it on the next webinar.
Okay.
Awesome, guys. Thank you so much.
Okay. What's next is we still have another webinar where Johan Hesselman, House of Prayers, will be doing, we're giving you guys a Kravis Network Adapter intro into our new programmable network adapters that we want to share with you guys. We also got the non-programmable ones, so it will give you some heads up on what is it, what they do, and you will see that which protocols are supported, because they support I think more than 10 protocols. So you can have a protopass, network adapters, Modbus adapter, a device net. So you will see on our next webinar. So Mr. Yuan will share it. And remember, we're still here. If you guys need codes, you need accounts, orders, technical support, we're here. Rikita, Kim Adams, and Mr. Yuan Hazelman, this is so. Okay, thank you very much for today, for joining. I really appreciate that. And good luck. And guys.